And then Conrad started just kind of hooking me up with podcasts. I didn't know, I'd never did any radio. I've never done any voice stuff. I started doing radio spots for Conrad on his show, and he started giving me names of people, and people would start calling me, like Terry Runnels and Medusa. And then Robbie E and I started a podcast called Why It Ended, which was pretty successful. I worked with Dutch Mantel. And then
I want to stop and talk about that.
Sure.
Why It Ended, when it like first came out, like they actually asked me to be on it. Like, I think that I was asked to be on it like one time.
Yeah, I think I asked you.
I'll be honest with you, bro. The concept of the podcast is kind of depressing.
It killed it.
Right. So it's like, you know, I mean, I do enough of podcasting. I didn't want to like do one where I had to reminisce and like basically the tenor of the podcast would be like, well, how come you never went to WWE? You know, like whatever. So, you know, like what happened to your career that it wasn't that you didn't become the world champion? So, you know, so, and I just like I'll be honest, I just wasn't really interested in doing something like that. You know what I mean? So I was like, you know, if I wasn't doing other podcasts, I probably would have done it. But it's like, bro, I do probably 4 to 5 hours a week on this stuff. You know, on top of my job, which is 40 hours a week.
So it's
like
more,
I work a lot. You know, I put in like almost 50 hours a week with this stuff. You know, between this and work.
All right.
It did have that effect. There are people who wouldn't do the show because of the concept, but it was a different concept, so it did well. But when Robbie left to go to NXT, I didn't mind ending the show, starting my own show. But before that, I interviewed Vince Russo, and Russo called me a week or two later, and he said, hey, I want you to be my Conrad. And I'm like, okay, well, here's the plan. And we worked together, as you guys know, for about 9 months. It really wasn't for me, and I decided not to do it anymore, and Vince and I are still on friendly terms.
Why wasn't it for you?
I had an idea which I thought could lead it to success. And like, part of that,
like, give me your take on this.
My take on it was that as Vince is misunderstood, Vince comes off badly a lot of times. Mm-hmm. And if we could focus on the good, fascinating parts of Vince Russo's career and stay away from that other stuff, the stuff that his base loves going at Meltzer. His base loves calling people marks, but that's a base of a few thousand people. But if you could get that Bruce Pritchard audience, if you could get, I saw the numbers when I worked for the Pritchard show for the Vince Russo episode. We're talking about, I mean, Joe can tell you, big, huge, fucking crazy numbers.
Vince is a draw when he's a topic of other podcasts. It's fascinating, isn't it? You know,
it's like, totally. And on WWE Network, too.
But, and I don't say this disparagingly, but Vince Russo as a podcast host is like Vince Russo as a booker. He goes with the wind. So he goes, oh, people love this, let's do this. Or people love that, let's move to this. And the concept was very much a Bruce Pritchard show. We talk about something in history. And every time we did that, it would go up a little bit. And then Vince would want to do something totally different. And it would kind of knock things off. And it had a limited success. You would be shocked at how unsuccessful it was download wise. And I think it was just because people thought it was just like another Realm Network show. It was another castrating the marks.
Yeah, because he's got so many, you know, it's diluted in all the product that he puts out. You know, it's just like, why is this, like you
yeah,
think,
it's almost like, it's,
just, it's almost shows, like, why is this different? Well,
it's almost like, right, it's almost like wrestling. You have so many hours now, you know, of the WWE product that's, you know, diluted everything from the way they approach storylines to everything. You know what I'm saying? It's, you got to concentrate on one or two things, and it's hard when you have fucking 80 shows.
And I thought with the thing with Vince is that even with all those shows, the real Vince Russo is a fascinating fucking person. Like, he's really interesting, and he is multifaceted. He's multi-layered. There's a lot of deep shit going on there, and we scratched the surface of it a little bit, but every time we did, there's a lot of pushback from his fans or pushback from him saying, this wasn't what we wanted. And, you know, I don't know about you guys, but I'm in podcasting to be successful. I love wrestling, but I want to have a successful show. And when I saw my show was as successful without Vince Russo as my show with Vince Russo was, I'm thinking maybe this is not the best use of my time right now.
Perfect example. Jericho interviews rock stars too. His wrestling fans obviously don't listen to that, but like, if you, when I told it, the first time I did talk is Jericho, I was like, you know, he does all the thing. I'm like, you know, I do rock. I go, yeah, to expand your audience. It's like, if you're just doing a podcast, you know, the funniest thing about it is that Vince wants to do podcasting the way like WWE books their show. They just want to like kind of like focus on their audience and not like expand the audience.